Welcome back, guys. So in the last video, we did the question based on the coplanar, like the three lines was coplanar. So the question was based on that. Here we will say that the question is find the angle between the two planes. The equation of these two planes is given. Okay. So let's check it. Suppose this plane, first plane, is like it's given like this. Okay, so this first plane that is given and its equation is given. The second plane is like, so there's two plane here. First one is this black marker, this one red marker, and the angle between these two plane is suppose theta, and the equation of these two plane is given. Suppose for the first one, the equation is 2x plus 3y minus z is equal to 7, and for the second plane, the equation is x plus y plus z is equal to 7. Now suppose if you see this plane from the front view, this plane, it looks something like this. If we see from the front view, this plane and this plane. So if we draw normal for this plane, it will look like this. And if the normal drawn for this plane, it will look like this. So suppose the angle between these two is theta, then the angle between their normal will also be same, that is equal to theta. So if any of we find the equation of this line, this normal vector, and the equation of this normal, then we can find the angle between these two vectors that we have already read. So how to write the that is the normal vector with the help of these two planes? That we will check. Suppose if I give the normal for this plane, this one, so its normal will be, we have seen in the previous video, the normal will be 2, this 2, 3, that is, this is in the form of, this is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to d, or if taken in the form of direction cosine, this will be in the form of lx plus my plus nz is equal to d, where d represents the perpendicular distance from the origin to the plane. So this 2, 3 and this 2, 3 and minus 1 will be the direction ratio of the normal vector. So suppose this one is the first normal vector, n1. So this is equal to 2y plus 3j minus k, 2y plus 3j minus 1k. Now for this plane, the normal will be looking something like this. Suppose this is n2 vector is I cap plus j cap plus k cap from there. So these two vectors we know, and then suppose the angle between these two is theta, because we have taken the angle between these two plane is theta, that's why the angle between these two normal will also be theta. So we have to find this value theta. So we know the this vector and this vector, and the angle between these two we know, so we can find this value theta. So from here, if I write that n1 vector dot n2 vector, this is equal to n2 into cos theta. So from here, cos theta is equal to n1 dot n2 upon the magnitude of n1 into magnitude of n2, n1 into n2, 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1 minus 1 into plus 1. So this is 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1 plus minus 1 into 1 upon magnitude of this vector into magnitude of this vector. So for this one, this is 2, 4, that is 2 square plus 3 square plus minus 1 square under root into, for this one, 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square under root. So this is equal to 2 into 1, that is 2 plus 3 minus 1 upon, this is 9 plus 4, 13 plus 1, 14. So 9 plus 4, that is 13 plus 1. So under root 14 into this one, under root 3. So this is equal to 4 upon under root 14 into 3. Therefore, from here cos theta is equal to 4 upon under root 14 into 3. Then theta is equal to cos inverse of this value. Okay, so this is the solution for this. So this is the approach how we solve this question. So in the next video, we'll be doing the concepts, the questions like in which a point will be taken and there will be one line and the reflection of that point we need to find, those type of questions. Okay, so thank you for watching.